Hello friends, thanks for clicking and welcome to my channel only for civil engineers. In this video we will discuss second part of types of doers. In the first part we discuss first four types of doers, and that was ledge doers, ledge and brace doers, ledge and frame doers, ledge, frame and brace doers. In this video we will discuss next fourth types of doers, and that are frame and panel doers, ledge or sash doers, flush doers and lowered doers. So let's start. Firstly we will discuss about frame and panel doers. Frame and panel doer is the most usual variety of doer, and it consists of a framework in which panels are fitted. So this is the image of frame and panel doers. Here we can see various panels are here. So this frame and panel doer consists of this framework in which these panels are fitted. In this image we can see this is the style, this one is also style, and these are the rails, that is top rail, this is the middle rail, this is the bottom rail. So these tiles are continuous from top to bottom, and these rails are joined to this style. The mullions, if any, are joined to rails. In this type of doer, the thickness of shutter depends on various factors such as type of work, situation of doer, number of panels, etc. But thickness of this shutter is about 30 mm to 40 mm. The thickness of these panels is about 20 mm. These panels are secured in position by grooves made inside the edges of this framework as shown in this image. The number and size of panels depends upon the architect's design or owner's desire, but the number varies from 1 to 6, and panels are molded to add to the beauty of the doer. So this first image shows fourth panel doer. Here we can see this is the first panel, this is second, this is third, and this is fourth panel. So this is the fourth panel doer. The second image shows two panel doer, and this third image shows six panel doers. The small openings, the shutters are of single leaf as shown in this image, while double leafed shutters are used for large opening. So this first image shows single leaf, and the second image shows double leaf shutters. This type of doer reduces the tendency of shrinkage and present a decent appearance. So next type of doer is glaze or sash doers. In order to admit more light, in addition to that coming from the windows, are the fully glazed or partly paneled and partly glazed doors are used. So here we can see this is the glazed or sash doors, and this first image shows fully glazed door, and this second image is partly glazed doors. In this image we can see this one is the glazed portion and this is the panel portion. So the ratio of this glazed portion to the panel portion is 2:1. The glass is, as shown in this image, this glass is received into the rivets provided in the wooden sash bars and secured by nails and putty or by wooden beads fixed to the frame. In this image we can see this is the paneled portion and this is the glazed portion. In order to increase the area of this glazed portion, the width of these tiles above this lock rail is decreased as shown in this image, and these are known as diminished tiles or gunstock tiles. It may be noted that the inclined lines at the corners of glass panel are drawn to indicate the glazing of glass panel. The glazed or sash doors are useful for hospitals, offices, libraries, showrooms, banks, shopping units, etc. Next type of doors is flush doors. A flush door consists of a framework of rails and stiles, and it is covered with plywood or hardboard. There are two varieties of flush doors, a frame flush door and a laminated flush doors. So firstly, we will see frame flush door. A frame flush door consists of stiles, rails, horizontal ribs, vertical ribs and plywood. So this is the image of frame flush door, which consists of these tiles, these rails, horizontal ribs, vertical ribs and plywood. The holes in horizontal ribs are provided for ventilation. The vertical ribs rest on rails. The hollow space, instead of being kept empty, is sometimes filled up with granulated cork or any other light material. A lock block. In this image, we can see this is the lock block, and the second image shows this is the hinge blocks. So this lock block and this hinge block should be provided to the shutter to fix mortise lock and hinges. The flush doors with hollow space are light in weight and cheap, but as they are weak, they have practically become obsolete. Now we will see a laminated flush door. This image shows laminated flush door, and the laminated flush door consists of stiles, rails, laminated core and plywood. So this image shows laminated core. The laminae of wood are glued together under great pressure. The plywood sheets on either side are also glued to the laminated core under great pressure. Thus, a laminated flush door is heavy and requires more material for construction. And last type of door in this video is lowered doors. In this type of doors, the shutters are provided with lowers, either fully or partly. So this image shows lower door. Here we can see these, here lowers are provided, and this one is the partly lower door. The lowers are arranged at such an inclination that the horizontal vision is obstructed, as shown in this image. Thus, the upper back edge of any lower will be higher than the lower front edge of the lower just above it. The lowers may be movable or fixed. So here we can see this is the movable lowers. In the case of movable lowers, a vertical piece of timber is provided to which the lowers are attached through hinges. As shown in this image, this upward or downward movement of the lowers can be carried out with the help of vertical piece of timber. The lowers may be either of wood or glass. The lowers should be kept sloping away from the inner portion, as shown in this image. This arrangement will prevent the entry of moisture from outside. The lowers doors allow free passage of air when closed, and at the same time maintain sufficient privacy. They are used for sanitary blocks of public buildings, residential buildings, etc. These lowers collect dust easily, and therefore the lower doors should be periodically cleaned. So here this video is end. In the next video, we will discuss remaining types of doors, and that will be collapsible steel doors, revolving doors, rolling steel doors, sliding doors, swing doors. So thanks for watching. I hope this video will be helpful for you. For more updates, subscribe my channel and don't forget to share this video with your friends.